We are beginning tonight with new developments in the smart meter debate. Capitola doesn't want them in their city. In fact, they've banned them. But the city council knows that it really doesn't have the power to do that, or at least not enforce it. And PG&E has threatened to install them anyway. So tonight, the great debate: continue to try and enforce the ban or lift it. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen with continuing coverage tonight from Capitola.
Well, Aaron, that's exactly right. A lot of debate tonight over those smart meters. Capitola City Council members asking how much it would cost in money and resources to enforce their ban on smart meters. The Capitola City Council votes to leave their smart meter ban on the books. But for now, police won't be enforcing it.
We're here to ask the council to enforce the law, to do what is necessary to protect the citizens of Capitola.
Until the CPUC states that it is illegal or unlawful to do so, we must follow by their rules.
A debate Thursday night in the Capitola council chambers, ranging from conspiracy theories.
The spy meters or murder meters are just one part of a bigger plan.
To health concerns.
Even with only 13% deployed, there's several places I used to go all the time, friends I used to visit, that I can't even go there. For me, being electrically sensitive, the second I walk into a building or a house, it is so horrific.
Stop Smart Meters Director Joshua Hart urges PG&E customers who don't want smart meters to lock up analog meters.
Urging people who don't want these smart meters on their home to lock them up. Unfortunately, we've just heard reports of PG&E cutting open chains and things, being very brutal and forcing these devices onto people's homes who do not want them, people who are getting sick from them and are fearful for their children's safety.
What's next for anti-smart meter customers is uncertain.
If the council and the other local governments won't enforce the law send out their police to cite and possibly arrest PG&E officials who are ordering these installations, then, you know, we maintain that the public has a right to defend our own communities.
One Monterey woman even said customers are talking about arming themselves to keep installation workers out.
People in Monterey have said they will take shotguns and sit on their porch if PG&E and Wellington attempt to install smart meters, and I'm sure there are people in this county who feel the same way. This is a critical issue.
At the end of the night, a 4-1 vote kept the ordinance on the books, but only symbolically. Well, there's still a lot to come on this smart meter issue, Aaron, as you might imagine. Now, PG&E has made a proposal to the State Public Utilities Commission that would add an opt-out provision called the radio off proposal. Now, but until then, until a decision is made on that, PG&E is offering a delay option in which you can call a hotline and have PG&E wait to install your meter on your home. Aaron.
All right. Thank you, Brittany. In the radio off proposal, the cost and feasibility of the plan is being considered, not the health effects.